So Be Quiet has finally done it and released some RGB fans. We're going to talk about what they are and why this is a pretty big deal for RGB lovers everywhere. So let's get started. Hey guys, Tiago with Classical Technology here. Remember to subscribe and smash that like button if you like content on PC building, GPUs, and of course, RGB. Now, I know that RGB sometimes is a little bit of a controversial subject for some. Some don't like it at all. They rather have their PC all blacked out without any type of lights at all. But remember, RGB on your fans doesn't necessarily mean you have to have what they call the rainbow puke or the multiple colors that looks a little messy sometimes if you don't do it right. So it doesn't necessarily have to be that. Sometimes really well-placed lighting, like let's say if you have a certain theme, even like a nice green or blue or white light that you can set these fans to, they can make a huge difference in your build. And after all, if you're gaming or if you have your PC in the room, a lot of the tempered glass nowadays is a little bit dark. If you don't have any lights in there, how are you going to see your hardware? Once I remember there was a guy that told me, why would I put a tempered glass panel on my computer? And even worse, why would I put lights inside the computer? He said a computer is meant for work under your desk and nothing else. I thought that was really quite depressing because if you guys follow the channel, we love doing water-cooled builds and RGB builds. I think they really bring the life into multiple types of PC building, and it's not something you want to hide away under a desk. You want to make it literally a work of art if you can, or something that looks really, really pleasing. So for those amongst us that really appreciate this, one of the biggest things that you can actually add RGB to are going to be your fans. Generally, in the case, you're going to have multiple fans, usually on the front with the radiator. You're going to have fans on the top for your exhaust, on the back, sometimes on the bottom pointing at your GPU, or a CPU cooler if you happen to have one as well. So your fans are a great way to showcase this type of RGB. At the same time, you still want great performance. Now, I've been using the Be Quiet fans for literally years now. Their Silent Wings 3 are fantastic. The first build that I ever did in their 900 series case, the Dark Base, I filled up that case with their Silent Wings 3 fan, both the 120mm as well as the 140mm model, because they provided really good airflow as well as being really silent. Amongst other fans that are often in the market and considered really good, such as like the Noctua fans, even the NBE loop fans for water cooling. Those are all great as well. I've used them in the past in different builds, but I've always definitely liked the Be Quiet fans. They have different mounting mechanisms if you want to place them on a radiator or in a case. Well, it's like the build quality as well. But the one thing that was missing is that I always had to add other lighting to the case so I can see my actual build. Now, with the RGB fans, if you want to add lighting that's extra aside from that, it's going to be very minimal, and it certainly makes your build considerably better. So there are going to be a few types here that they've just announced and are releasing that you have to know about. Of course, each one is going to have both a 120mm fan as well as a 140mm larger fan if you have like a larger AIO, or if your case can accommodate a larger setup like that. And then you're going to be able to choose from basically two different types. One is going to be just a PWM, that means you can control it with your motherboard, and then the other one is going to be a PWM but high speed. I believe it goes all the way up to 2500 RPM, and these are going to be better suited for you to place on a radiator, something with really, really good static pressure. That's going to be, either a water cooling radiator or even one of the AIOs that are out on the market. The other one is going to be a little bit lower airflow, maybe around 1700 RPM, but it's going to be more suitable as a case fan for you to get airflow going through, which nowadays with the RTX 3000 GPUs and the AMD GPUs, a lot of heat are generated by these really high performing beast of GPUs. So you need all the airflow that you can get. Having a little RGB light next to them, certainly going to be even more impressive. When I first started to put RGB fans in my PC builds, the first thing that you actually notice is that, all right, now you have a lot more cables to deal with. Now, while this, it still has two cables coming out of each fan, one is going to be for your fan header for your PWM control. And then you're going to have an ARGB, which is going to be the 3-pin that's available on many many newer motherboards now, that's going to be where you're going to plug it into the ARGB. Now, the really nice thing that I liked, often motherboards may have maybe two at most of these ARGB headers. So generally, you're going to need a splitter or some type of controller. The triple pack of these fans comes with the controller already included. So now you can plug in six of your fans to this controller, and you can just plug that into your motherboard, to the digital RGB header on your motherboard. And then that's going to allow you to control the RGB with the motherboard software. Like if you have Asus, for example, an Armory Crate or Mystic Light and MSI, you can sync up all of the fans, make it one light. And yes, you can even turn it off if you would prefer not to have RGB at certain times. Let's say if you sleep in the same room as your PC or something like that. So that's a really nice touch. It's not a proprietary controller, which I really liked. Some of the Lee & Lee fans do have a more proprietary controller, the way you connect the fans. And while it still uses an ARGB connector for the header, it's much nicer to have it like this, like the Be Quiet fans come. That way, it's just a lot more flexibility. You can move them around from system to system, and you're not dependent on any specific proprietary type of hardware to connect your RGB. You can use the controller or not. If you want to use like some type of a splitter, you can certainly do that as well. These fans will run normally just like any other fan if you don't connect the RGB. And as usual, one of the best things about Be Quiet fans, they give you good performance, good airflow without really compromising on noise. Now, the regular PWM version will go around 20 to 21 dBA decibels. Now, that's going to be fairly quiet. Now, of course, you have to keep in mind, these are RGB fans. They're going to be a little different than sort of just a regular standard industrial fan. There are other fans, including Be Quiet's, Silent Wings 3, which may perform a little bit better in general. They may go a little bit higher, or something like Noctua, you can get higher RPM, but in that case, you're also going to be getting more noise. And then it's really a case of diminishing returns, unless you're doing it in like an industrial setup or something like that, where you really wouldn't want to probably put RGB fans anyway, but some of you may try, so nothing wrong with that. But still, considering how these are designed and with that really awesome ring type of RGB, still impressive the performance that they get, and you're not really compromising on much. If RGB is an important part of your PC, I would have no qualms in using these as also really nice performance fans. I don't think the days of, having to go without any RGB to get the best performance out of your fan, those days are really, I think, behind us. And while technically with certain fans, you still can get higher RPM, higher performance, I think nowadays you do have to balance your build out with not only sort of the performance side, but also it's nice to get that high performance with something that's very aesthetically pleasing. And I think most of you will agree, these do look really, really fantastic, and it's very well done, not over the top at all. You can definitely make a very, very tasteful build. Now, the 120mm high speed version goes up to 2500 RPM, and it still manages to stay around 31 dBA. So the noise level is really not that bad for that type of performance. Now, if you put this up against a radiator, it's going to give you great static pressure, great airflow. So you really see, combining the performance with the RGB, you're definitely not going to be missing out on much. Now, of the regular 120mm fan, you're going to get roughly around 41.51 for the CFM. That's going to be the airflow. That's going to be the number you want to look for if you want to use this as a case fan. The air pressure, the H2O number, is 1.66. This is going to be for more of the static pressure for your radiator. And for the high speed version of the 120mm fan, the airflow is going to be more like 52.3. Of course, that's going to come at a little bit higher noise. Remember, this one's going to go up to 31 dBA compared to 20, and the air pressure also goes up to 2.6. So if you really want to do this on a radiator, this is the one that I would go for. Or if you're just looking for the maximum amount of airflow in your case and you're not really as concerned about the noise, this is certainly the one that I would choose. Otherwise, the other one's fine for your case airflow, as well as even if you do it on a radiator and you just want really quiet and you don't have anything particularly hot that you need to cool, then the regular 120mm fan should be fine as well. And of course, if you do want maximum case airflow and you happen to have a case that can, hold the 140mm fans, the high-speed version, while staying at around 2200 RPM, will give you 71.7 for the CFM. So that's certainly some pretty high airflow. The static pressure, around 2.3, the H2O, if you use that on a radiator. So definitely, these fans have some pretty good specs. Of course, you can always find certain fans that are non-RGB. And of course, if you pick and choose amongst the high-end fans like Noctua, Joshua, or even some of the other Be Quiet fans, you can find some that may go higher RPM, may give you higher airflow, or even better static pressure, but these certainly combine the RGB element with the, you know, the cool integrated controller with some pretty good performance. So if you want to put good fans in your system, you really don't have to compromise on not having that RGB look. That's certainly going to be one of my favorite things about these particular fans. Alright guys, so I plan to do more in-depth sort of views on this. This is just like a first look. I do want to thank Be Quiet for sending me these fans in order to evaluate, take a look. I think they look great. I'm really happy with the way that they came out. So far, they're staying quiet, looking great, and performing really well. As you've seen in the video, I put them in my desk case, which can be a little tricky for airflow just because of the way that it's laid out, but they've been performing really well, and I look forward to also putting them on different cases as well. So let me know if you have any questions down below. Let me know if you're using fans that are high performance, and if you'd like for them to be RGB fans, let me know what you think. Remember to smash that like button, subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next video.